Hello guys, today I'm just home cooking. I've been cooking all day long. How you guys doing, by the way? You guys feeling okay and doing fine? I am so tired, but I just feel like showing you parts of what I do today. And please keep watching. Thank you all for always for being part of here, being part of my family. Keep on watching, guys. See you. So I'm making fried rice. I'm about to make fried rice. I have been cooking all day long, and this is my shrimp. I love to fry mine before I add it to my fried rice, and sometimes I'll be so tired I just season it in microwave, but mostly I fry it, guys. So I've been using this oil, frying a whole lot all day long. If you look at this, that's my shredded chicken. Not shredded, I diced it, and that was fried too. Meanwhile, this is let me cut this over. This is just everything. What do you call that? Assorted everything. Turkey, chicken, pomo, beef. I have black pomo. I have white pomo. That is actually going here. I'm making stew. That is going there. Look, pomo has been made. I'll be traveling, so I have to cook for my family. Stew is going on. That is ready. I just need to add oil and this. And that's it. I've prepped a lot for my fried rice. I just need to fry. Look at that. Let me show that. This is my veg, mixed veg. And it's ready to go as well. Come on. Look. Jollof rice is done. I'm trying to cook for the family, but they already finished the jollof rice. It was a lot more than this. This is the spring onions and the onion. That's actually for the fried rice. These are my peppers. I have the green. Look at that. Yeah, I have the green, the red, hind. Look. Let me show them my egg. I popped my egg. Egg has been cracked. I'm going to fry, stir fry the egg as well. And my pot. Guys, if you don't have this cocoa in here, I don't know. What is it called? If you don't have it, I don't know. It's really good for massive cooking, especially when you want to make that, get that taste of, what is that thing called? Smoky jollof rice. This pasta smoky jollof rice. You need that pot. It's just another doorway to open up and see. What kind of lifeline will be waiting there for me? Still, white rice. Yeah, I made white rice too, right? Mm-hmm. And your girl is tired. So this how I make my See you guys. I just boil my pepper. You know the pepper base that has what is that thing called? Red bell pepper, tomatoes, the habanero, scotch bonnet, and then with onions. So this is all about this one. And of course, I'm gonna add two of this to it. And that's it. And then put my already baked, because you guys know I always bake my meat. I always bake my meats ready. So that was taken out of a freezer, microwave. Who is right there disturbing my video?
Yeah.
So guys,
the pepper base is ready, and as you can see, that was all together of red bell pepper, tomatoes, the scotch bonnet pepper, onions, And it was blended and cooked, and it's ready now. So all I need to do is just to put a little bit of oil, 2 cubes of the chicken flavor, the seasoning, and also add the assorted meats. In there I have turkey, I have cow meat, I have the cow skin, you know, I have the honeycomb. I have a whole lot of things together in that bowl, so I'm just going to add it up to the stew, and that will be it for that. And you know, I'll be moving on to the next level, which will be the fried rice. As you can see now, the stew is ready to go.
Guys, my pepper is ready, the stew. And it's time to taste. Lizzie, taste it.
A little bit more salt.
A little bit more salt?
Yeah.
Guys, I just don't feel like having anything like that. It's just another doorway to open up and see. What kind of lifeline will be waiting there for me? I need to bury all these fears and let them fade away. I'm not scared, I'm prepared. So guys, this is what I get to do every day after a long time in my kitchen. I just have to come around here to take a walk. I have all my family here. They are not allowing me, actually. They will let me take my walk in peace. So, I'm just here trying to give myself, you know, take a walk. I'm just out here taking a walk with a whole family, guys. We are friends, we are families around. And everybody's out there. I mean, we are all out here. Just walking around where I live. And I'm taking a walk, yo. A lot of people are used to this air bonnet.
Guys, to go to the house.
One of my sister even shaded me last week.
House to walk.
Telling me I wear air bonnets everywhere. It's so comfy, guys. All right. So, it is really, really comfy on me. It makes my life, you know. And I left my vlogging stick in the house. So, guys, I'm not feeling too well. So, I'm going to just go for like, maybe probably 4,000, 5,000. I don't think I'll be able to meet up with my target. I usually go about, the least I take every day is 7,000 steps. So most of the time I go by 10,000, 14,000. But today I've been cooking like the whole day. I have been cooking, guys. And my kids, they decided to follow me. They won't even let me shine. I should have just come out here all alone. But they kept saying they gotta go. So they are not actually allowing me to be me. But it is what it is right now. I'm just gonna keep moving. Catch you guys.
Let me quickly show you what I have here. I have the Atarodo, the Scotch bonnet pepper. Look at that.
I got them in cases and from a Spanish store just around where I live at. Scotch bonnet pepper. We call it Atarodo. This is my tomatoes. I got them the same place, from the same place, and also in cases. They come in boxes. Some people do get theirs in pound. They just weigh and buy. But I get this from the case. I mean, the case size in a box from the Spanish store. Not from the African store. From the Spanish store. And my red bell pepper. These actually come in bigger cases, but this was what they had when I went there. They have this in 15 pounds. It also come in 25 pounds, I think. It's 25, 15 pounds, I think. So I got this case in 15 pounds from the Spanish store. It's actually called where? LA Market. LA Mats. Yeah. This is what I usually do. Whenever I get them in cases like that, I just portion it. If you can see now, I've packed them in a bag, in bags. So I portioned it. I did just two of those in a Ziploc because I won't be needing too much of it. So this is the rest of the Scotch bonnet pepper in the bag. So whenever I run out of this one in the Ziploc, I just come back to refill until it's done. And then my tomatoes, I bagged everything. So you guys will be hearing a lot of Henry Lomatawa, you know, that kind of a thing. Because I will just call on my son to go get pepper for me to cook. Henry, go downstairs, go get me pepper. That's what I just said in Yoruba. So you'll be hearing a whole lot of that. And sometimes you'll be like, Henry Lotasima Fisebe. So guys, let's go. This is all that you'll be getting familiar with in my family. Thank you. That's the scrambled eggs, guys. I love to just do scrambled eggs. I'm gonna fry it right now to be added to the fried rice. And you know, I have everything ready. I'm about to scramble the egg and just add it to the fried rice. It's gonna make it, you know, more delicious. And it's gonna give it that continental fried rice look and taste that I wanted. Also, I have the bell pepper, the yellow, the orange. Yeah, I have the yellow, the orange, and the green, also the red. All them colors together, I dice them into the same shape, and I'll be stir frying as well with the onions. And my garnish as well with the spring onions to make it have a better look and also give me that continental taste. I use butter for my fried rice base, and here I'm just melting it, and I'm just gonna add the already parboiled rice into the base, and that's butter. I'm trying to melt it and I will be just mixing it together before I can start to add all the veggies and the rest of the ingredients into my rice to make it that, I mean, to give me that continental look and also the taste. Obviously, the pot is not going to contain all the rice, so I'm going to split it into two. I'm going to be making a lot of fried rice, and that's because I'll be traveling. And also, I will be making it into two pots, different pots. It's just going to be basically the same. And now I'm just basting the pots with butter, adding rice and the rest of the ingredients. And that will be it for the fried rice. Guys, it tastes really good. It looks really good. It is the type that I love to always eat. It is the continental. I call it continental fried rice, guys. Check it out. Guys, my fried rice is all done and ready. I'm just got off the stove now. I actually put it on really low heat, and I'll be cutting it off now. It's ready, but before I wrap it up, of course, I'll be garnishing with my spring onions. I like the color of spring onions, and of course, the flavor. This is going to infuse another flavor into my cooking. And of course, I'll give it a quick stir. That's it. So today, right, I'm more or less of a cook in this family today. I actually cook the whole day. I'm tired, guys. I'm not gonna lie to you. I made more money and I'm proud. Still, fried rice, jollof rice. Sorry, guys, that's all I can show you. I have my beans in the refrigerator. What else do we make?
That's it.
You sure? Yeah, that's it. Yeah, and the white rice. Of course, we made the white rice, remember?
Oh, yeah.
So you guys, when I'm gone, just do your... You don't need to make anything. Just probably a bar.
Yeah.
And you guys should be okay. So guys, this is all about it. Thank you for being part of this family. Thank you for always coming back. Thank you for always tuning in. Thank you for loving me, loving my family. Please keep doing some more. I want to say thank you. I really do appreciate you. And please do not mind the noise in the background. Those are my kids. We have visitors around. So, guys, don't mind all that. So, thank you, thank you, thank you for being part of us. We appreciate you. And trust me, I'll see you in my next one. Bye for now.
I got the pretty, pretty lady with no like, no stress. She got her own, but she needs some love. She got her own, but she needs some love.